Good morning. Previously, we learned about the basics and limits of inductor-resistor circuits, or LR circuits. Today, we are going to derive the equations for current as a function of time and the time rate of change of current as a function of time. For this LR circuit, assuming the switch, which has been open for a long time, closes at time t equals zero and stays closed.
Flippin' physics!
Before we get started, please realize these derivations are very similar to the derivations we did for resistor-capacitor circuits, or RC circuits, and the motion equations with a drag force. Here we go. Going back to the Kirchhoff's loop rule equation for this LR circuit, 0 equals EMF minus current times resistance minus inductance times the time rate of change of current. We can move inductance times the derivative of current with respect to time to the left-hand side of the equation, and we now divide the whole equation by resistance. And now we are going to use u-substitution.
U-substitution!
We let the variable u be equal to EMF divided by resistance minus current. Now, I will say that these initial steps, including the u-substitution, are the ones which are the easiest to forget in this derivation. So I do suggest you indicate somehow in your lecture notes to specifically remember those initial steps, please.
Well, yeah.
Sure. Lecture notes.
Now, realize we have the derivative of current with respect to time in our equations. That means we need to be identifying infinitesimally small changes in variables in these equations. Looking at the equation variable u equals EMF divided by resistance minus current, if we identify the infinitesimally small change in variable u, or du, Bobby, what is du equal to?
Du is equal to, well, EMF and resistance are constants, which means they do not change over time, so there is no change in EMF over resistance. So the infinitesimally small u, or du, equals the negative of the infinitesimally small current, or di, right?
Correct, Bobby. And when we substitute u and negative du into our equation, we get inductance divided by resistance equals the negative of the derivative of u with respect to time, all equals u. And then rearrange the equation to get u and du on the left-hand side, and everything else on the right-hand side. We now have du over u equals the negative of resistance divided by inductance times dt. And now we can take the integral of both sides. And we need to identify the limits on both integrals. The limits on the integral on the left-hand side, where we are taking the integral with respect to the variable u, are just u initial and u final. Billy, what are the limits on the integral on the right-hand side of the equation?
I'm not sure.
It's an integral with respect to time, so I'm asking what the initial and final values for time in this integral should be.
Okay. Time initial is when the switch closes, which is time equals zero, so the initial condition for time is zero. The final condition for time, well, after a long time, the current is...
We are not looking for what the current is after a long time. Remember, we are solving for equations for this LR circuit as functions of time.
Okay, I get it. Time varies from zero to time t. The final value for time in these equations is the variable t because we are solving for equations as function of time. So that makes sense. Thanks for your help, Mr. P.
You're welcome, Billy. Now, let's take some integrals, starting on the left-hand side. Bo, what is the integral of 1 over u with respect to u equal to?
We know the integral of the multiplicative inverse of x minus a constant a with respect to x equals the natural log of the absolute value of x minus the constant a. So the integral of the multiplicative inverse of u with respect to u equals the natural log of u.
Wait, what happened to the absolute value?
Yeah.
In this case, u equals EMF divided by resistance minus current, and current varies from 0 to EMF divided by resistance. That means the variable U is never negative. Therefore, we can remove the absolute value from the natural log equation.
Oh!
Then the left-hand side of the equation is the natural log of U from U initial to U final. And the right-hand side of the equation, well, resistance and inductance are constants and can be taken out from the integral. And the integral of 1 with respect to time is just time.
Billy, please work on it from here.
Absolutely. Let's substitute in initial and final conditions on the left-hand side. The natural log of U final minus the natural log of U initial equals the natural log of U final divided by U initial. Substituting in limits on the right-hand side gives us negative resistance divided by inductance times time. This is just like deriving RC circuits and drag force equations because now we take e to the power of both sides. On the left-hand side, e to the power natural log of u final divided by u initial is just u final divided by u initial. We can multiply both sides by u initial from here.
U final equals EMF over resistance minus current final. And U initial equals EMF over resistance minus current initial. However, current initial equals zero, so U initial actually equals just EMF over resistance.
Cool! Thanks, Bo!
Yep.
We can substitute those equations in for U final and U initial, move EMF divided by resistance to the right-hand side, multiply through by negative one, and factor out EMF divided by resistance. And we get that the current as a function of time in this LR circuit equals EMF divided by resistance times the quantity 1 minus e to the power negative resistance times time divided by inductance.
And EMF over resistance is the maximum current in the circuit, so you could substitute current maximum into the equation if you wanted to.
Absolutely. Well done. Notice this fits our limits for current because when we substitute 0 in for time in our current as a function of time equation, we get e to the power 0, which equals 1. And 1 minus 1 equals 0, and we already showed that the current in the LR circuit starts with a value of 0. And when we substitute infinity into the same equation, we get e to the negative infinity, which equals 0, which gives us EMF divided by resistance for the final current in this LR circuit after a long time, which again matches what we determined earlier for that final steady state current in the circuit.
Nice!
Yep. And we can also determine the time rate of change of current as a function of time. All we need to do is take the derivative of the current equation we already derived. Bo, what do we get when we take that derivative?
Sure. The derivative with respect to time of EMF over resistance minus EMF over resistance times e to the power negative resistance times time over inductance. Well, EMF and resistance are both constants, so the derivative of EMF over resistance with respect to time is zero, and negative EMF over resistance can be taken out of the derivative. The derivative with respect to time of e to the power negative resistance times time over inductance equals, well, we know the derivative of e to the power a times x with respect to x equals a times e to the power a times x. So the derivative with respect to time of e to the power negative resistance times time over inductance equals negative resistance over inductance times e to the power negative resistance times time over inductance. Resistance cancels out, and a negative times a negative is a positive, and we get that the time rate of change of current as a function of time equals EMF over inductance times e to the power negative resistance times time over inductance. And we already showed that EMF over inductance is the maximum value for the time rate of change of current in this LR circuit, so we can substitute that into the equation.
Excellent, Bo.
Thank you.
Yeah. Again, notice that this fits our limits because when we substitute 0 in for time, we get e to the power 0, which gives us the initial time rate of change of current equals EMF divided by inductance, which is what we derived earlier. And when we substitute infinity in for time, we get e to the power negative infinity, which is zero, which means we get zero for the time rate of change of current after a long time. Again, exactly what we derived earlier. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.